Over the past week, we've had some moisture across Oklahoma, and Josh, that can impact the planting of canola.
Yeah, and for the positive, for the most part. We are looking out behind us, and we are having quite a bit of rainfall in particular areas. Most of the canola area that we still expect to see some acres in canola here in the state have received some really nice rainfalls over the last couple weeks. And the biggest thing to remember about canola, as opposed to things like wheat and maybe some of the other things we'll plant this winter, is how shallow we have to plant it and how good we have to have it for that canola to come out of the ground really fast and really timely. And so conditions like we have behind us, to where it's a little wet and it's a little soggy, this is kind of not what we want either before or right after. Here in a couple of days, if we don't get any more rain, this is the kind of seed bed where we expect to see good things coming out of your canola. But with the good rainfall, we talked a couple weeks ago that how dry we were going to need this rain. We got it. So we're setting ourselves up nicely for some of this winter crop planting here. Some of the conditions and some of the issues we have with it being so warm, it's okay if we stretch back into maybe that first week of October. It's still pretty good. For insurance windows, we're still looking at that October 10th. We still have good potential a little bit after that if they're not going to be insured, but that October 10th is traditionally a really good time to stop planting canola. Always can find one of those good years and those couple of fields that do really well after it. But if you're planting canola, as long as you have good rain, maybe not a heavy 3-inch downpour in the future, it's good to get it in with this good moisture we have right now.
And when it comes to canola production, we have to remember that it's in the field to help clean up a wheat crop as part of a cropping system, but also there's other options as we move through the winter too.
Yeah, that's one good thing to continue to talk about canolas is we talk about all these other things that crops besides wheat can bring in. And we have a lot of folks kind of guessing around what they're gonna do this year. The wheat price is not great and they're looking for something to move out. Canola is still a really good option. We talk about all those benefits that it has, the breaking the weed cycles and the disease cycle, the insects, bringing in herbicides that we traditionally can't go into true wheat ground. When we start talking about cover crops and planting, especially if we're gonna have cattle out on the field, we wanna make sure to get it out as soon as possible because we want that good growth to it. We can't wait and delay. Sure, cover crops planted later will do just fine. We've seen them planted all the way through December do just fine as far as the spring growth. You won't get any winter growth, and we're still wanting to protect that soil, add all those benefits in starting in the fall. This is a good time for producers looking at canola or producers looking at cover crops to really get a lot in, take advantage of this good soil moisture we have out there and get some of these other alternative winter crops or winter systems in right now.
Talk about why it's important for producers to look at their overall cropping system and not be reactionary towards what's happening right now, but to take a bigger picture overall of their field.
That has to be a decision mechanism that we have. Adding in that diversity always helps us on the back end. If we can make it through this year and gain that financial support in future years and still being able to keep our head above ground this year, it's really good to add in that diversity. And we have, especially with as much cover crop options as we have right now, especially if you have a herd of cattle that you're looking to feed something for and you can bring in that cash flow during the season, we have good options to bring in some very diverse mixtures or just diverse cover crops here that can be quite successful, have been proven to be quite successful for future seasons. So we're talking about some of our small grain mixes. We're talking about some of our things like the turnips and radishes. Bring in the same things that canola does, but it's just something a little bit different. So you have some of that legume, grassy cover crop mixture into something here. Great feed for cattle over that wintering time and really can add some diversity to your wheat system.
And this is a great opportunity for producers to go to their county office and talk to the county educators to kind of learn what options there are in their specific county.
Yeah, and that's exactly right. Talk to your county educator, to your state specialist, to some of the seed dealers to find out what your options are, because that's gonna pay off better in the end whenever you go to actually go put these things in the ground, is getting everything laid out before you and picking the best option that you have available, because that's really what we want to do in these real tough economic times, is look at all the options we have and go with what works best for our system.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Josh Lofton, cropping system specialist here at Oklahoma State University. And we have information of an upcoming field day at the Eastern Oklahoma Research Station near Haskell. This will be an opportunity for producers to learn about Oklahoma State University research into stalker cattle production, some of the new technologies to help them manage cattle, and information about the value-added cattle sales across the state. They will also be looking at different varieties of Bermuda grass and how to manage them in the area. The Eastern Research Station Field Day will be from 9:30 to noon on October 8th at the station just south of Haskell. For more information about the field day, visit our website, sunup.okstate.edu.